Okay, hi traders, here's a new video. First of all, the risk warning, your invested capital might be at risk. Don't trade with money you cannot afford to lose, and this video is not investment advice. So this video is another trade school high frequency trading example and explanation video. Yes, it's weekend. You see we have the assets are closed, and so it's time to do some recovering of those trades which I have already done to explain you more the how EMAs, how Bollinger Bands, and how price action works with them together, and why I should, why I took some trades, and what you should aware and be careful about when you are doing your tradings, yes, and your trades. So let's see if we let's start again immediately. But before we are going to start, I have to show you those things which I have explained in my ebook. Get this ebook; it's for free. You find the link in the description. This ebook contains the most important candlestick pattern, chart pattern, and binary option turbo trading concepts, market condition, trend identification, rejection, and candlestick mass, and a lot of more concepts which can be applied to any kind of time frame and any kind of financial instrument. So get this ebook; it's for free. You find the link in the description, and in the description you will find also the link to the Facebook group. Join the Facebook group, don't miss it. So those things which I'm going to discuss here in this kind of the high frequency trading example and explanation video of these trade school videos are those things which I have explained in the ebook, yes, in this videos regarding and to corresponding to this specific topic of the ebook. And when I'm referring to, for example, the Bollinger Bands, you should know what I have told you in this video about the Bollinger Band. And if I'm referring the EMAs, you should watch those things which I have told you in the deep explanation videos about the EMAs, yes, because I cannot cover all the things over and over again, because else every kind of video would be a few hours long, yes, if I had to recover all those things which I already explained in other videos. So watch those videos, yes, they are important. So, okay, let me see if I can show you now those trades which I have done. So assets are closed. So let me get the video. Yes, we are here, and let's start. And now I'm going to explain what's going on. First of all, the market condition. You see here, we have here something what I would say it's a ranging market. Yes, you have here this kind of area. You see price is ranging around this area here, more or less. Yes, you see price goes up, down, up. Yes, down, yes. And we are in the ranging market. You see also the Bollinger Bands are flat. Yes, the one deviation, the two deviation, and also the 200 EMA is also flat. Yes, that means we are in ranging market. Yes, and here we see a double. Here we see a double bottom. Yes, here you see a double bottom. Yes, touched twice the 100 EMA. Yes, retested the 100 EMA, maybe also the 200 EMA, because this here is that what I'm almost explaining here. Look at this. This is nothing else than a fake breakout. Yes, we got a consolidation area between the 200 EMA and the 100 EMA. Yes, and this consolidation area here in between was a fake breakout. Yes, of this 200 EMA, yes, and here we have another fake breakout. Yes, you see this here. Yes, that price tried to break this but got a rejection here from the 100 EMA. All in all, we have a ranging market. Yes, and you see double bottom, and here we got here in something what looks like a pullback, but this should be validated. Okay, so okay, that is what you have to know. That is what you have to understand. Yes, that we have here ranging market. So now I'm going to start this video, and as soon as I enter into a trade, I explain you. Okay, in this kind of scenario, I can tell you this immediately, that here in this kind of case, there are only the two options are open here. Yes, or you do a call if you get a rejection from below. Yes, or you do a put. Yes, and what of those things would be much better? Yes, better would be a put instead of a call. Yes, why? Because you see, first of all, here that the wicks are getting lower and lower and lower. That means we are getting here, we're doing here something what I would say in the downtrend. That is a minor downtrend in this complete downtrend. Yes, you see lower, low, lower, low, lower, low. This one here was only a retracement, but the most of one are going up. And then we are here below the 50 EMA, and below the 50 EMA, we have also a 20 EMA, which is crossing here as the 20 SMA, the middle Bollinger band in a ranging market, yes, and the 20 EMA is pointing down, yes, and we are below this. And this candle already got a rejection from the 50 EMA, yes, that is what you should know, and that is also maybe the reason that I would do a call put here. Let me see what I'm doing. So my market is not moving at all, yes, you see it's moving down, yes. I'm explaining there something, yes, and yes, there is also a nice resistance area. I want to do a call, yes, but price, okay, let me show you this. Yes, let me first of all end of this, and so I will explain this after. You see, this candle here got a rejection from this area here, yes, which would be maybe also a nice resistance area, which I do not have drawn. I was only focusing on the 50 EMA, which is, where the previous candle is showing me that price is mostly, yes, with the upper wick is greater than the lower wick of the previous candle, which is showing me selling pressure, yes, and because we are, and you see, it was only a doji. So, why I have done this put? Because this candle closed below this area. I waited to get a better entry point. You see, if I would have entered exactly on this level, it would be mostly a draw, yes? But because I entered above this level, I expected that price would go down, that we would get a rejection from the 50 EMA here, yes, but it doesn't touch the 50 EMA, yes, that was this, but I waited till price got at least to the opening price of the previous candle, yes, to get the best possible entry point. If price would not have done this, I would have get some other point. But important is that you get in a downtrend an entry point above the closing price, yes, and an uptrend below the closing price. Yes, that means, let me show you this. That means, for example, we have here in this uptrend, we try to enter, see this, so we try to enter below this level, yes, below this level, yes, and in a downtrend, we try, in a downtrend, here for example, this is the closing price, we try to enter above this level, yes, here, this area here, yes, this area here. This is where we try to enter, yes, into a trade, and in an uptrend, we try to enter in this kind of area here, yes, because a doji can happen at any time. And overall, those kind of dojis will happen mostly in this kind of consolidation areas, yes, in consolidation areas. If you are getting in such a consolidation area, you can expect that there will happen a doji. I show you this here. You see here in a consolidation area between the 200 and the 100 EMA, you see dojis. That are dojis here, yes. Dojis can happen everywhere, yes, but mostly in a consolidation area. And here maybe in between of those support and resistance levels, look at this, you see also, yes, here in this kind of area here, yes, here, this is one area, yes, and here we have another one, here, yeah, you see, here, maybe a little bit more, wait, here, so, you see, in between, you have what? A doji, yes, that is it, here we have also a doji, yes, here we have this one, yes, and then we got here maybe, here, crossing of the EMAs, yes, here, something like this, yes, and what we have in between, dojis, yes, that is it, and if you get here such kind of doji, spinning top or something like this, yes, you have to decide for the right direction and try to get above or below, depending on the trend, yes, above or below the opening, the closing price of the previous candle. Okay, that was this, yes, only to explain you this. So, and after this doji, Yes, and we are still below this 50 EMA, and price did not have done a fake breakout, because that is what the important is. Yes, because if you have a downtrend, you are getting below EMA, and you do not get such kind of candles. Yes, only such kind of candle which is indecision. Yes, you can expect that. Yes, that the downtrend will mostly continue. Yes, that is what this about is. Yes, there will be mostly continue. That there will be not a fake breakout. Yes. Obviously, you have to be carefully if you get here a breakout of this with the wick. Yes, if this candle would have touched this 50 EMA again, the probability of a fake breakout would be much higher. Yes, that is what you have to understand. But this candle here got a rejection from this area here. You see where the dotted line is, yes, and that shows you that that we got already a rejection before this, so we didn't touch this level anymore, and that means that there will be most with a high probability no fake breakout. So, and that was the reason to do put, yes, in this kind of condition. And you see, I entered into a put without any kind of rejection, only to get this high, this level here, this this is the highest point of this doji, yes, and to enter to get a margin of safety, yes, and to get good entry points. So, and yes, the 20 EMA is still pointing down, yes. Also, the 50 EMA is starting to pointing down, yes. But because the EMAs can be used like every other support and resistance level, and maybe there is also a confluence. You see, it's confluence here of the 50 EMA and the support and resistance levels here, yes. Because you see, we have here everywhere a lot of wicks, yes. And yes, and that shows you then also that this area could be much be stronger. So we are going really fast downwards. We got a small rejection, yes, and another small rejection. So, and let me see. We broke directly through the 200 EMA. So, and we got here already a few fake breakouts of this area here. Yes, you see, but there was almost often, yes, the 100 EMA, which was the reason why the price was reversing here. Yes. Important here is also that we have still the 200 and the 100 EMA flat. Yes, and that means that next, yes, price will most probably, because I showed you this, we have here ranging market. Yes, we have here ranging market. The lower wick is bigger than the upper wick. Yes, that means already that we have much more selling pressure. So we have here this ranging. Yes, price is ranging in between here if you are doing this. Yes. So, yes, we are here almost, and it has also a little touch upping touch. Yes, you see here that this is a little bit higher than this one. Yes, so, yes, then that we can expect now. What can we expect? What I have told you so often, yes, that price will range around the 200 EMA, because price already has done this. Yes, so 100, or maybe also around the 100 EMA here. That is really critical area. Yes, that is what I'm telling almost often as a DNA crossing. Yes, because here now price is starting. If we are going down, price is going to cross everyone. Yes, but we are here in ranging mode. Yes, you see, this is ranging area. A breakout below, yes, would have to be confirmed. Yes, that has to be confirmed. But this candle here got straight through this level, yes, but got this rejection at the last few seconds, yes, of the expiration time, which shows the getting in of buyers. So let's see what I have done. And I entered immediately into a call, yes, because I understood that we are getting a ranging around the 200 EMA, yes, and the 100 EMA. I don't know around what. Yes, we're gonna range, yes, but the breakout that this would be again a fake breakout, and that's the reason. And you see, I'm pointing there also on the wick, which showed me that there is buying pressure, maybe it will be a doji, I don't know, yes, because you don't know if price will be rejected or not. Can't be a doji, it looks like a doji, but it can be also that price will get back above this, which would confirm that this was a fake breakout, yes, and that is only based on the market condition, yes. If the market is a trend, this would be a trend, this trade would have been gone wrong, yes, or maybe it would have been gone right too, but price would not have closed above this level, it would have been closed maybe here near the support and resistance level of this EMAs. Okay, so that was already, I think I have explained this kind of situation and those trades in detail. Yes, important here was again that you understand the market condition, that you know that price is often, yes, if there is not a strong trend, price tries often to range around the EMAs, of almost the higher EMAs, the 200 EMAs, the 100 EMAs, yes, and on the next, yes, I have not done this trade maybe, yes, no, I don't have done this, because I have noticed, but you can expect here also that on the next candle, yes, that price, yes, that had to see, but the next candle would be maybe a bearish candle, yes, because this would be maybe only a retracement of this, yes, of this downtrend. Let me see if I'm right here. Let me do play. So for the last few seconds before I finish this video, yes, and but the candle is not moving at all. Yes, it's going up again. But we have here a nice area that I would expect that price would go down further. Let me see, because it's really on this area. Yes, and this doji is also a nice resistance area, but it's not visible. Yes, and then the video stopped. Maybe it yes. I think it would gone down further. Yes, because we are still into a trend. We got here a few touches. Yes, and so I would expect that price would go down further. Also, if this candlestick is looking like this at the moment. Yes, because we have here this kind of nice area, which is a nice resistance area. This candle closed at this resistance area. So I would expect that we are going to continue this kind of downtrend. Okay, so that was it. If you like this video, do a like. If you didn't subscribe, subscribe. And if you have something to say, drop me a line in the comment section. So I would say stay safe and bye-bye.